People.
Hello, how are you?
Hi, how are you
good
doing?
Good to see you, darling.
So good to see you.
God, I've never seen so many roses in my life.
Thank you so much.
So the Daily Kos community raised enough money. We set out to raise for 10,000 roses. Within about an hour and a half, we had enough for 25,000.
Oh my gosh.
So this is only about 6,000 of that amount. There are more coming later. Amazingly, your office decided to donate half of them to Walter Reed. So Walter Reed would get 15,000 roses tomorrow.
Nobody deserves it more than our wounded veterans.
So I'm very excited that the community was able to come through. And thank you for your amazing work, for your leadership, for being a survivor, given everything that the Republicans have tried to do to destroy you. And you always seem to come out stronger than before. And so excited to... They were excited to participate.
My goodness.
And what I love about this is that it's a positive gesture in a world where everything is so pervasively negative. And so people wanted to do something nice for once.
Isn't that great? Well, I thank you, because none of what we do would work, whether it's policy or politics or whatever, without the outside mobilization. We can only do so much internal maneuvering, but the difference is made by the outside mobilization. As President Lincoln said, public sentiment is everything. With it, you can do almost anything. Without it, practically nothing. And you all have been a force for public sentiment weighing in, for honoring our democracy. And the manifestation in votes and showing up at meetings and the rest made all the difference in the world. The manifestation of support with these roses is so encouraging, and I hope it's a source of satisfaction to the donors that our veterans who need so much warmth being surrounded by these roses. Not that it satisfies everything, but as a token of our appreciation to them. So thank you for enabling me. This is a regifting.
Yeah, the best
a
kind.
A regifting of thousands of roses.
The best kind.
Daily Kos
was fairly young the first time you took the speaker's gavel. It was a whole different world. And you didn't even make the cover of any of the news weeklies. It blows the mind to think how far we come. So to me, it feels different. How does it feel like to you now compared to the first time you were?
Well, first let me thank Daily Kos for the mobilization that you have done to make a difference in policy and in the lives of the American people. The social media, and you obviously were the pioneers in using the social media to organize and to message, mobilize and message, that is something that is such a source of hope to those of us doing the inside maneuvering, because you keep thinking, if only people knew what a difference this policy makes in their lives. If only people knew what the administration is doing to degrade the air our children breathe, the water they drink, the safety of their food. If only people knew, it would make a difference in policy. It could help change the minds of those who might be wavering. So the difference for me is, okay, now we have all the opportunity in the world because the people will know. And you make Daily Kos and others make the floor of the gallery of the House of Representatives an all-American town hall.
Oh my God, it's amazing, isn't it? How many women were in the House when you first got elected?
When I first came, there were 23 women, 12 Democrats, 11 Republicans. On the Democratic side, we made a decision that we were going to increase our numbers. So up till this last Congress, we were up to 65. The Republicans were like 20-something, but because we made a decision. And we made a decision in this election in recruiting and supporting. And so, and some of our women members self-recruited. Women marched,
yes.
Women ran, women voted, women are in Congress. So now we have
95
Democrats.
Democrats,
over
right.
100 altogether, but 95 Democrats.
And not just women, but candidates of color. I mean, we had so many first Native Americans and openly gay and bisexual and Muslim.
Leading into this election, our House Democratic Caucus was over 50% women, people of color, LGBTQ. Again, we had Muslims, but men, and that. So diversity in terms of confession, as we say, religion. After this election, we went from over 50% to 60% women, people of color, LGBTQ. And within that, the first two Native American women ever to serve in the Congress. I mean, that is so exciting.
So exciting. I love those pictures where you contrast the Republican side of the aisle and then the Democratic side, and you see the difference is so, so dramatic. So I think that is a testament to the work you and the DCCC and the entire Democratic Party has done.
And your activism. Don't remember. It's all of this is a conversation unless people vote. And getting out that vote, messaging for it, mobilizing for it, every step everybody took made that difference. And it is interesting to see the contrast. We'd love to see more diversity on the Republican side, though.
So I have one more question, and this is sort of taking a realistic view of the next 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
Republicans have the Senate, they have the White House, we have the House. If you could accomplish one thing in that reality at the end of these 2 years, what would that be?
Well, I could talk about individual legislation, as yesterday we introduced H.R. 8, which is the gun safety, gun violence prevention bill, or we could talk about H.R. 1, which is about integrity in government and ending the role of big dark money in politics. So each of them has its value. But I would say, in terms of how we see success, is to see it in a more overarching way. And that is to say, one of the challenges to the economic stability of America's working families, and therefore to our democracy, is the increasing disparity of income in America. So I would like us to make a judgment about many of the things that we do as to, does it narrow that disparity? Does it address that concern? Because that lack of confidence that people have is unfortunate for themselves, but unfortunate for our economy as well, and in part for the middle class, which is the backbone of our democracy. So I would say to look at a challenge to the economic stability of America's working families and how bills fit into that, and also to address the challenge to our planet. Mm-hmm. This is an overarching issue of many of the things that we will do in terms of energy, in terms of the economy, economic investments and the rest, tax policy and the rest, address the climate crisis. So these two things do come together at a certain place about making values-based decisions. The reduced economic disparity, income disparity in our country as we protect our planet. Now, under that, we have our For the People agenda, which is about lowering the cost of health care in terms of prescription drugs and preserving the benefit of the pre-existing condition, building the infrastructure of America, building lower healthcare costs, bigger paychecks by building the infrastructure of America in a green way. Again, H.R. 1, bringing integrity to government in a way that gives people confidence that decisions will be made based in the people's interest, not in the special interest of dark money and politics. So it all fits together. So rather than taking it one bill, because we'll pass the bills and we have to get them passed in the Senate and signed by the President, and we come back to public sentiment.
Yeah.
The public's, in the public, there's wide support for the Dreamers, wide support for gun safety. You know, there's some issues.
Everything,
there.
Pretty much that our agenda. There,
but can we pass the Senate?
Mm-hmm.
Only if those people weigh in.
Well, thank you so much for your time. Is there anything else you'd like to
well,
say?
I want to thank Daily Kos because you have not only accomplished so much in what you've done and ever-increasing aspirations and successes, but you've been a model to others to know their power, to use the social media to mobilize, to message, to raise money for the causes that you're concerned about, and to make your statement, this beautiful, beautiful statement, to pause, to stop, and smell the roses.
Thank you so very much. Appreciate your time.
Thank you, Michael. Thank you, darling. Congratulations to you. You should be very proud. We're all very proud.
We're excited about the next 2 years.
Thank you.
Best of luck.
Thank you so much. To be continued.
That's yes.
Right. That's right.